are the names of the five finalists. One of these girls will be Miss Universe of 1969. First, Miss Finland. The second name on the list is Miss Israel. Number three, Miss Australia. Judges, one last opportunity to evaluate you. I'm going to ask you each a question. I'll ask you each the same question. Now, this question can be interpreted in your native language if you wish, so that all of you will not hear the answers of each other. I'm going to ask you, and you, all four, to step over here into the soundproof booth. Miss USA of 1966, Judy Anstep, will lead you into the booth. So right over here, you four. And the manner in which you answer the question is what is important, not the specific answer itself. So step into the soundproof booth. Would you please step right down here, Miss Finland? Right out here. Our judges are out here. To the judges, I'd like to have you direct your answer. Now, you speak English, don't you?
Yes.
All right. Your question is, in the next day or so, a man will land on the moon. If a man from the moon landed in your hometown, what would you do to entertain him?
What a question. Well, we haven't got very much of entertaining things, I think, in my home city, because it's quite a small city, not places like here anyway. Well, I would go out and have some fun with him, I suppose.
I'm sure he'd be very happy. Miss Finley, will you step right back up on your pedestal here, and let's have Miss Israel up here, please. Right up here. Now, Miss Israel, I want you to speak to the judges. This is your question. In the next day or so, a man will land on the moon. If a man from the moon landed in your hometown, what would you do to entertain him? You don't know what entertain means? What would you do to make this man from the moon have fun? Make him enjoy himself. Have fun. In your hometown. It's difficult to say in English, then say it in Yiddish. Go right ahead. Now go ahead. You speak Yiddish.
I will do the best that I can to do to him, for the best reception for him.
That's very good. I'm sure it'll be a nice reception. Thank you. All right, let's have Miss Australia, please. Just step right up here, facing our judges, if you will. Miss Australia, right up here. The judges are out here. The question is this. In the next day or so, a man will land on the moon. If a man from the moon landed in your hometown, what would you do to entertain him? Don't worry about the photographers. Tell the judges what you do to entertain this man from the moon.
What a mystery.
Anything that is fun in your hometown.
I don't know, do a song and dance.
Very good. I'm sure you enjoy a song and dance. Here you go, right back up here. Now, let's have Miss Philippines, please. Miss Philippines, step right up here. Right up here. And you speak English well, I know that. Miss Philippines, in the next day or so, a man will land on the moon. If a man from the moon landed in your hometown, what would you do to entertain him?
Oh, it's the same things I do.
I think if he's been in the moon for so long, I think when he comes over, he wants to change, I guess.
Very good, Mr. Willoughby. Here you go. Now, Miss Japan. I know that Miss Japan does not speak English. However, we do have interpreters. Now, the question is, in the next day or so, a man will land on the moon. If a man from the moon landed in your hometown, what would you do to entertain him? Will you please tell her that question? Ask her that question in Japanese. Is that the same question? Briefly, what did she say?
Mr. Powell would like her, like the man in the moon, to see her city.
Very good. Mr. Japan, will you please step up here? Thank you, girls. And now, judges, the decision is up to you.